Welcome back to making this grungy iPhone. To start off, guys, I just want to say 90% of you guys are not subscribed. If you enjoy my content, I'm going to be doing loads and loads more of useful Blender tutorials. So if you like it, please subscribe. Leave a like, a comment, any of those will make me incredibly happy. In this tutorial, we'll be working on the metal, making that nice and grungy. Add some wear to it, and we'll also be working on those particles on the ground, right? You see like a dusty texture on that wood, something that gathers piled up there, and it's in textures. We're not gonna do everything in particles, of course, to give our system a little bit of a break. So there we go, let's get into Blender. Full. Now, what else can we do? This metal looks way too clean. Right, we can't just get away with changing the screen. We also need that metal. And for the metal part, I find that there is an incredible one that we can use. All right, so I think this is the main material of that phone case. What I'm going to do is hit plus, and I'm going to search in Blender Kit once again. Everything is free we use. I'm going to use for edge wear. Search for that. Move all the way to the left. There's one right there. This one, edge wear with imperfection. It is amazing. I use it for a huge range of things. And we can just copy that edgeware map like that. Go to our main material. And we can simply just paste that in right there. Now we can use this color to, for example, change the color of our material. So if we want that, we can press Shift A, color, and search for our mix color. Just swipe that in there. And we can use this edgeware for the vector. Right there, right? So Control Shift click on that edge wear to see how it looks. It's not looking great. Shift A, search for a color ramp, swipe that in there. And now we can actually change this edge wear a little bit better. All right, so I'm gonna zoom in a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. And we can change the edge wear size, for example, first, right? So it's only gonna appear at those edges. Maybe change this a little bit as well. There we go. So now we have more of those scratches on the edges, and this is already looking way better. Something like that. And it's a very, very small object. It may work even better if we make this object in a bigger size and then scale it down later. But it doesn't matter, right? We can just change this manually. Something like this is already looking way more used. All right, imperfection size, we can just change this as well to be a little bit smaller, something like that. And so then we can just connect that color ramp to, for example, the displacement. Shift A, search for a displacement map, and move it in between. And just Control Shift click on your principal BSDF to see that material. Now we have to connect the color ramp to the height instead of the normal. There we go. And what I'm also going to do is set this to a very low scale, 0.05, perhaps, maybe even smaller, 0.005. Yeah, it's already looking a little bit better. Maybe even smaller. Maybe even smaller. All right, something like that. Beautiful. Now, that already looks like we have some scratches. I'm not sure if they may be actually on the wrong side. Yeah. I think we have to invert that a little bit. So what we can do is just move that color ramp, right? Just connect them to different sides and it will pretty much move it in. Just like that. Beautiful. Scale it even further down. We can just keep tweaking this until we're satisfied with the actual results. All right, I think something like that looks fine. Beautiful. We have some scratchy metal already. And I'm also gonna connect this color to the vector there, and we don't want this to be white, and actually we want this to be swept, right? I want to swap A to B because we want the blue parts to be on the blue, and we want the edge wear to be pretty much not white but maybe a little bit darker. Let's make that completely white, and I'm also gonna connect that color ramp to the roughness of our phone. All right, there we go. And then I'm gonna press Shift A, add a new color ramp in between there, and Control Shift click that. And the
The black parts are basically going to be very glossy, and the white parts are going to be incredibly rough, right? So we're just going to be tweaking that a little bit. I'm actually going to tweak only the white color to be more dark, because I don't want those white parts to be completely white, because that will make our surface completely rough. I want it to be a little bit glossy still. So that means that we have to downplay that white color a little bit to the darker gray areas right there. Control shift click that principle. All right, so we now, if we set this to completely black, it's going to be completely rough, or sorry, completely smooth, and change this to white. It's going to show more of the blue color because it's very rough, right? So I want this to be somewhere in between, perhaps somewhere right there. It's looking fine. And our displacement map may just be a little bit too strong still. So what we can do is just tweak those colors a little bit so they're going to be closer together. All right, it's going to play this to white, actually. Set this to, and actually I'm going to add a new color ramp next to that, so we don't use that color ramp to tweak the other values that we have, but that this color ramp only affects the displacement. All right, so let's just tweak those colors a little bit so they're going to be closer together. And perhaps a little bit less strong as well then. Alright, so I don't want this too harshly. Somewhere like there. And now we can just tweak the edgeware size. For example, if you think it's too big. Oh, sorry. 0.05. We can just tweak those values a little bit more. And imperfection sizes as well. Play that down. There we go. So it's going to be much smaller and have only scratches on those sides. Maybe a little bit bigger. It's fine. Something like that is already looking more grungy, right? So you can see me just playing around with it quite a lot to get those grungy things going on a little bit. Now, this may, in your opinion, even be too strong of a displacement, but I just want this to be a phone that has been used for a long time without like a cover. Okay, so maybe just downplay this a little bit like that, so we have at least some kind of a clean area there. And that is already looking great, in my opinion. Okay, beautiful. Now, something else you could play around with is Ambient Occlusion. It's not going to play a huge part in here, so I may just show you an example of how we can use that. Okay, so what Ambient Occlusion does is it tries to take the parts of your object that are close to, well, other objects, for example. For example, if we add an ambient occlusion to this phone, it's going to try to calculate what parts are close to other parts of your mesh or to other objects as well. So, for example, it's going to be calculating the ambient occlusion based on this floor. So, wherever the parts of the mesh are close to the floor, you will have a texture there. All right, you will have a little bit of a black value where parts are closer. And I think the best way to show that is just by adding Shift A, Ambient Occlusion, Control Shift click it. And you'll see that if I tweak the distance, if I can zoom in a little bit, if we tweak that distance to, for example, well, we can just change it right there. You can see that the bigger I make this, the more, can we actually see that? Give me a second. We need a color ramp because we're working on very small scales, and just swap that more together. There we go. So this ambient occlusion node is going to take into account where we have edges, right? And we work very small, so we have to hold shift when we move this distance value. But you can see, for example, now where it's close to the ground, where it's close to another object, it's going to give you a little bit of this black value. Right, so if I swipe this more to the right, you can see that we get more of that black value to where it touches the ground. And that is very nice to use, for example. Well, in this case, if your phone has been lying there for a long time, that is where dust will gather up, right? That's where it will build up a little bit more. And it works quite well for walls and stuff as well, right? Because edges and things that are, well, placed on top of each other, a phone lying on the ground, a wall that is, well, it is perpendicular to your floor, that is where things just build up in those corners, right? Dust is floating around in your room. Whenever you walk, You have like a little bit of wind going on. If you open your door, dust is floating around and it will stop when it hits a wall, right? It can't go further. So it is going to pile up more in those corners, in those edges as well, right? So wherever you have that, there's going to be some buildup. And in this case, if you place your phone on, for example, a dirty object, for example, if you place it on the ground for a second when you're outside, then, well, that's just going to get a little bit more dirty. So I want a little bit of a dirty look there in this area, which means that I'm going to press Shift A, color, and mix color. Just swipe that in between and connect that color ramp that we just made and set that to the vector of that mix color. All right, Control Shift, click that pencil BSDF. And we don't want that color to be white. We want this to be like some kind of brownish color. And we want to switch those colors A and B to there. And now we see that we actually need to tweak that color ramp even more. All right. So it's just swipe that white value a little bit closer there so we can see that gradient better. Maybe move it to the left a little bit more. So we only have that bottom part. So now you can see we have a little bit of a white value at that bottom. And we can make it even lighter to see it more. Right there, you can see it already. Now we can set this to a color. For example, well, what is the usual color of dirt? It's some kind of a brownish, a little bit more brownish color. Right, so brownish, make it a bit darker, perhaps. We can even make that black if we want to show even more dirt. But I'm just going to make it nice and brown. Maybe make it a little bit more visible. Something like that. We can even tweak that color ramp a little bit more to have more or less of that material show up, right? So if I move this to the right more, we will have more of that brown color. Maybe desaturate it a little bit, make it a little bit darker. Just like that. So we have the bottom parts will just be a little bit more dark because they're getting more dirty, more used, things like that. Beautiful. We could do the same thing for the floor if you want. All right, so select your floor plane. That's going to be a very easy material also from Blender Kit. And we can also add an ambient occlusion there, right? Ambient occlusion and Control Shift click that, Shift A, color ramp, swipe that in there. And then just play around with those values and the distance as well. If we want the distance to be lower, and then we can set it lower and then just swipe up that color ramp, right? So now you can see that where the phone is lying on the floor, we're getting this darker black color and we can use that mask for whatever we want pretty much. All right, so whether we want that to be dirt, whether we want that to be dust, it's all gonna be possible. All right, so to track that into your scene, just Shift A, add that color, mix color there, use that color ramp for the vector and Control Shift click the print spot and then just swap those A's and B's and move the white a little bit closer. Right there. So you have now that white color going on at the bottom part there. Amazing, isn't it? Right there. So now we can use that for whatever we want. All right. Now, I don't want this to be impacting the scene too much. I'm just going to make this a little bit more dark, perhaps. I would make this a little bit more white for dust. Very nice way to do that, by the way. If we set this to white, for example, if we want there to be like a few dust particles, we can just use this in combination with a noise texture. All right, so if we want this this color ramp to be more noisy, we can add a noise texture and Control Shift click that for a second, Shift A, color ramp, swipe it in between, move this a little bit closer. All right, so now we can play around with the scale. You can crank that up way more, and the detail as well, and then the roughness as well, right? We want this to be quite rough, so it can actually represent more of a dust look. Something like that is looking decent. Move those blacks and whites closer. All right, this is going to be like our dust map a little bit more. We can even make the scale bigger by just typing that in manually. Something like that looks more like a dusty look. All right. So then we can just mix those two color ramps by adding a math node, for example, and then connecting the two of those colors we just had. And my Blender is so slow with zooming in. Now we can just Control Shift click on that add node and we can just swap this up for example, a multiply, Let's see if that works. It does not. Let's see, less than. Less than works. All right, so this is gonna be like the dusty white texture. Less than is what we're gonna be using. Okay, and then you just Control Shift click on your principal BSDF again and connect that less than math node to the vector instead. All right, that is looking not well at all. Swap those colors. There we go. That's looking better. So now we have some white particles going on there, and we can even just make this brighter if we want. And we can press Shift A, add a color wrap after that less than value, and just move those a little bit closer together. All right, so let's see which one we need. Control Shift click that if you want more information. I want those whites to be stronger. I'll move it to the left a little bit. And I'm also going to just use a little bit more of our ambient occlusion like that, and maybe just scale this down 150. No, that's too much. 1500 perhaps. There we go. Yeah, that's looking better already. Maybe 2000, and maybe we have too much roughness. Yeah, there we go. That's looking way better. Change the scale to 2500, and there we go. We now have way more of a dust look. So now when we actually apply that look on our material, Control Shift click on the principal BSDF, you can see that we have some kind of a dust pile up there. It may be too strong for sure. We can just change it by making this color a little bit darker, right? For example, like that. So now we have some dust piling up there. Beautiful. It can be quite light, actually. There we go. Looking quite nice. Maybe make it a little bit more brownish, the color, so it's to make it look like there's some of that brown shining through that we have in the floor. Something like that. It's looking quite nice, in my opinion. All right, maybe even darker. So it isn't that visible, but a little bit. Something like that, right? That is looking nice. All right, so that is pretty much how you can affect your entire scene with adding masks and materials very easily. And that dust on top is looking very nice as well. I can even add more dust, for example, 12,000. So just have that a little bit stronger on top. Maybe even make them a little bit bigger as well. Change the scale to like 0.07. Make them a little bit bigger and more present in your scene. And maybe just change this to 6. There we go. Nice and strong. Strong dust look on our phone. Amazing. All right. So that is pretty much it for that tutorial. I'm going to render this out and then I'll be back. And we can have some final remarks, some final feedback. Right, so the render is done. You can see it looks quite nice, but also quite dirty. Now, I over-exaggerated those textures a little bit, of course. There's a lot of dust, a lot of scratches. But you see what I mean, right? You can use this up to the point where you can make things look very dusty, very dirty. Perfect for abandoned house things, abandoned themes, post-apocalyptic themes. Whatever you can use it for, please do. Because this is, in my opinion, a great way to get some of those nice, dirty looks on your objects, right? Even with only the fingerprints and the scratch textures, you can get a long way. But that dust, I think it's just an additional step into achieving some of that realism, right? Dust pileup, which is looking quite all right. Well, if you enjoyed this tutorial, please leave a like, a comment, or a subscribe. I would be happy to see any of those. And have a great day. I'll see you in the next tutorial. Have a good one.